them polls. I don't know about you, but it sounds like Kentucky is ready for a new governor. Mackenzie and I stand before you this evening, humbled. Humbled by your support, humbled by your trust, and humbled by the outcome. And so it is in that spirit I find myself saying for the first time tonight that I am honored to be the Republican nominee for governor of the Commonwealth of Kentucky. And there will be more people to thank at the end, but I do just want to say thank you to the best campaigner I know, my wife, Mackenzie Cameron. Babe, you are my best friend, you are my rock, you are my inspiration, and you are a Proverbs 31 woman, and I am blessed by you. And let me just say, won't she make one heck of a first lady? Yeah. Huh? And thank you to all of you that are in this room tonight, and to those of you that are watching at home that made this win a reality. And of course, a big thank you to President Donald J. Trump for his support and his endorsement of this campaign. Let me just say, the Trump culture of winning is alive and well in Kentucky. You and I together, we proved that no obstacle is too great, no barrier is too large when concerned and committed Kentuckians come together around a common purpose and vision rooted in ideals that have propelled this nation forward since its very beginning. Those ideals being faith, family, and community. Our Commonwealth and this country were built on these ideals, and all I have tried to do in this primary is be a voice for those principles. And this campaign has tried to embody the promise of America, that if you work hard and if you stand on principle, anything is possible. And tonight we proved that. Tonight we proved that here in Kentucky, the American dream is alive and well, because here in Kentucky, you aren't judged by the color of your skin, but by the content of your character. So to anyone who looks like me, know that you can achieve anything. Know that in this country and in Kentucky, all that matters are your values. But I've got some disappointing news. Sadly, Andy Beshear wants you to believe that dream doesn't exist anymore. He wants you to believe that dream and those ideals are old-fashioned. The new religion of the left casts doubt on the greatness of America. They embrace a picture of this country and this Commonwealth that is rooted in division, that is hostile to faith, and that is committed to the erosion of our education system. Andy Beshear is resigned to live in a Commonwealth where violent crime is high and the workforce participation rate is low. He's content preside over the abandonment of our inner cities and the desolation of our rural communities. Now, the governor during this election will try to take credit for things done by our Republican legislature, but no amount of window dressing will absolve him of his actual record. Our people are smart. The governor cannot pretend to have hit a triple when everybody else knows that he was born on third base. Play ball. Play ball. That's right. Play ball. Since he has become governor, Kentucky has 27,000 fewer men and women working. Our workforce participation rate is lower than it's ever been. Violent crime runs rampant in our largest cities. Fentanyl is ravaging our communities. The left is trying to hijack women's sports. And our schools are on the verge of becoming breeding grounds for liberal and progressive ideas. But rather than face these issues head on, this governor sits idly by. Rather than promote a culture of work, he told people to stay home for 2 years. And rather than create a culture of collaboration between the Kentucky State Police and local law enforcement, he's opted instead to sit on his hands and turn a blind eye to a statewide increase in crime. And rather than hold Joe Biden accountable for his failures at the southern border, he embraces the far left's open border policies. He vetoed legislation that would have stopped biological men from competing in women's sports. And rather than speak out in support of parents and grandparents who have been called domestic terrorists by the Department of Justice simply because they care about what their children are learning in school, he said absolutely nothing. I'm here to tell you tonight that a governor who will not speak out on these issues and who will not stand up for your interests has abdicated his responsibility to the Commonwealth and is not fit to lead it any longer. And new leadership is needed now more than ever. Look at what Andy Beshear has done to our education system. Now, when he became governor, he appointed a new Board of Education, and that Board of Education hired a new education commissioner for the state by the name of Jason Glass. Now, Mr. Glass recently said that any teacher who expressed concerns about the gender ideology curriculum that's making its way into our schools, that teacher should find another job. Andy Beshear's education commissioner told hardworking teachers, and I know there are a lot of them, my wife Mackenzie taught for about 7 years in the Oldham County school system. We love our teachers here in Kentucky, and the Republican Party loves our teachers here in Kentucky. But Jason Glass said that those hardworking teachers got to find another job because they won't buy into the far left's ideology. Ladies and gentlemen, that's not the right answer. The right answer is that Jason Glass and Andy Beshear need to find another job, and we will help them do that in November. But that is why this race is so important. And it's why it's so important that we as Republicans come together. And several of my fellow travelers on this race for governor have called me to congratulate us on our victory. And they ran spirited campaigns because, like you and me, they care deeply about the future of the Commonwealth. And they know to get Kentucky back on track, we have one mission. And that one mission is to retire Andy Beshear from the governor's office. And together we can do that. Together we can make that happen. Together we can have a better and brighter version of Kentucky. Together we can make sure Kentucky has a governor who stands up to Washington and against Joe Biden. Together we can empower our teachers and prioritize parents' involvement in the educational opportunities of our kids. Together, we can keep our streets safe from crime and drugs. Together, we can make sure our small businesses and our churches are never shut down again. And together, we can make sure that Andy Beshear is a one-term governor. Let's go win this thing. God bless you. God bless our Commonwealth.